before they headed off, the builders planted shrubs to cover the whole estate's construction screen. And woe betide the mother who tried to dig for spuds. It wasn't gravelly ground she found as her garden centre spade cut cleanly through the urban sprawl of insulating foam. The lonely, flapping tome of a cement bag struggling through the dross. And when she straightened up to ease her back and cast an eye over the breeze-blocked wall, and down along all her neighbours hurdled garden walls, their purse washing shimmering on the line. She knew their perfect lawns, the clean magnolia finish to their walls, was down to the dump they'd made of her corner site. And so on she dug, past broken slates and concrete caked, down to the tempered ground that was trampled down by the dancing Kaylee Day, and on to the ground where the dead men go, and the maggot feeding plagues. Till at last, her spade struck the bedrock, and there she lay. And she placed three seeds, each in her own collarbone hollow of stone, and eased all the dirt and muck, all the debris. And turning, she squatted and peed, sat content, singing to herself, let them keep their perfect lawns. The neighbor's one-eyed cat surveyed the mess she made, and he saw it all through scent of loam and spade.